2010 FIFA World Cup, I want you to know the top 5 landmarks according to me. After watching this, you'll look like a local with your knowledge of Durban. The Durban Port Control Tower, known as the Portnet Tower, also known as the Tower of Strength, is about 67 meters long. Not only does the tower serve as a functional port building, but also communicates visually the functions of the wind and the tide for the people of Durban. This tower was made by KwaZulu-Natal for KwaZulu-Natal to accommodate KwaZulu-Natal's demanding climate. The tower's top floor accommodates an open plan operations center with an uninterrupted 360 view of Durban. The floor below has a search and rescue room. 900 cubic meters of concrete was used to construct the stunning tower. The Durban Harbour is the busiest cargo port and container terminal in the Southern Hemisphere. It is also a step over for cruise liners and is increasingly popular for foreign yachts. It looks so cool. The Durban Harbour is the biggest container port in South Africa and the 9th largest harbour in the world. The sugar mill is the largest in its kind in the world, able to handle about 80 tons of sugar an hour. The three silos have a storage capacity of up to 520,000 tons of sugar. There are also daily guided tours of the terminal. The Umgeni River mouth is a few kilometers north of Durban's natural harbor. The river is approximately 232 kilometers long, with a catchment area of 4,432 kilometers squared. The Umgeni River mouth is the most accessible and popular birding spot in Durban. It looks like the Sydney Opera House or the London Eye. It's the Moses Mabhida Stadium, put right next to the Kings Park Stadium, also known as the Absa Stadium. The two put together make a masterpiece. The Absa Stadium was built in 1891 and renovated in 1990. The stadium has a capacity of 55,000 and is used for both soccer and rugby. The stadium has hosted events such as the Rugby World Cup in 1995. The Moses Mabhida Stadium, on the other hand, is a new full functional stadium ready to host the 2010 FIFA World Cup. If you're wondering what Fundo thinks are Joburg's top 5 landmarks, then click on his video posts. So when you land for the World Cup, at least you'll know what's where and why.